When in doubt, ask the experts. We're happy to be launching expert panel at People's Cafe, because what is better than hearing it from the experts who have been there and done it all? You can hear our panel of experts talk about things that matter in the world of corporate, your business, and your career. You can expect loads of trending talks on future of workplace, digital marketing, wellness, technology, and so much more. Today's expert panel is on the topic, building resilience in pandemic through lifestyle and nutrition. We are aware COVID-19 has changed many of our daily routines in a way no one really anticipated. Many of us are at home more to minimize exposure. Isolation and being at home can elicit the temptation to eat snacks that are high in sodium, junk food, and low-quality meals that provide instant gratification for our taste buds rather than nutrient-dense whole foods that can also be delicious. This is a challenge for many in times of social distancing and self-isolation. Reboot yourself with our expert panel, Building Resilience in Pandemic Through Lifestyle and Nutrition. Your takeaways include nutrition and lifestyle practices to bring peace, balance, and resilience in your lives. We have with us our expert, Dr. Avantana S. Bhandari, who is a wellness advisor and author with over 15 years of professional experience. She holds a PhD in nutrition and practical training in clinical nutrition and dietetics from Potsdam, Germany. She has worked as an academician at the City University of New York at New York, USA. She has authored 6 books in the field of food and nutrition, and her motto is staying healthy and happy. She uses the DES approach, and that stands for diet, exercise, stress management, and sleep management in her consulting practice. So welcome again, Dr. Avantana. And I would like to start by asking you, how has the pandemic affected our lifestyle and nutrition, and especially for working professionals and women?
First of all, thanks so much, Priyanka, for having me over. It's really, exciting, as always, for me to talk about wellness and how to keep fit and healthy and happy, as I always say, during all the times, but especially so given the unique circumstances we find ourselves in these days. The pandemic, COVID-19 has become kind of a synonym for the word pandemic for our generation, at least, because it, you know, came as a bolt from the blue for us and sort of still remains an enigma. We are still trying to find out what COVID actually is. It's changing its forms, how it impacts our health, how long would it last is the question on most people's minds. And to say that it has changed our lifestyle and eating habits and nutrition would definitely not be an understatement. Because COVID-19 has impacted our lives both in a negative way as well as in a positive way. Mm-hmm. I, being an optimist, I kind of try looking at the positive things life has to offer, and definitely COVID did that for our lives. Mm-hmm. Talking about what shifts it has brought in our lifestyle is primarily our work-life balance kind of got skewed completely. Mm-hmm. The thin line that we always had between personal and professional lives kind of blurred, because most people started working from homes, and the daily routines got impacted. Families were all, thrown in together, and all their routines had to be managed. Domestic responsibilities increased, which was, a kind of added to our professional responsibilities. Mm-hmm. So what happened is that kind of gave rise to stress in our lives, mm-hmm. something that we weren't used to. Mm. It caused anxiety. It made our lives more social with our family members, which we were missing earlier. So that for some was a positive, while for others, it was probably too much to handle. As they say, during the holidays and the Thanksgiving dinners, we talk about abroad that people have these very uncomfortable conversations. So for some, it had a negative impact. For others, it had a positive impact. But all in all, since it shifted to what our comfort zones were, we had anxiety, we had stress, we had sleep disorders coming into our lives. The sleep cycles got impacted. And therefore, in some ways, we started living a life which we were not used to. Mm-hmm. And that was very uncomfortable for us.
Mm-hmm.
Lifestyle part dealt with, it had a very unique impact on our eating habits.
Mm-hmm.
We started eating out of the packet more often, just because it was more convenient. You were sitting on your laptop and suddenly you didn't realize that it's almost lunchtime. You don't have time to prepare fresh food or, you know, the home-cooked meals or the canteen meals or prepared meals that we were used to. Takeout stopped, delivery stopped. So what to do? I mean, you definitely have work to finish, and therefore you just probably took a soft drink, probably took a drink which was loaded with sugar and opened a pack of chips, and that was it. You thought, well, that's dinner's lunch is sorted. When it was dinner time, again, the same cycle repeats itself. You have no time to prepare meals. Your work is suffering, and you have the stress of finishing the job at the cost of your health. So as you mentioned, when we started this talk, that during the pandemic, we changed our healthy eating habits into acquiring a lot of faulty eating habits by way of high salt, high sugar, high calorie, high fat. Some people also got into this newfound hobby of trying out a lot of new things in the kitchen. We were flooded with photographs of these kitchen adventures on social media. But when you actually saw those pictures, more often than one, we saw, adventures in the kitchen of gulab jamuns, or some really laddus or desserts, or those baked goodies. Yeah. And those were loaded with oil, loaded with sugar, butter, and cheese. So those kitchen adventures and those social media posts, although, I mean, it's a healthy thing. I always encourage couples to cook together, families to cook together. Mm-hmm. But the entire recipes that were being used were definitely not healthy. So we kind of got into this nutritional deficiencies. Mm-hmm. Rather than enriching ourselves, enriching our bodies with the right kind of foods, we were indulging in a very skewed, as I say this word, cycle of eating. Mm-hmm. And the pandemic, for the first few months, it went on like this. And then I think good sense prevailed. People started realizing that this is not the way to do it. They were sitting at their desks for hours at end without any physical exercise. People who were used to physical exercise had to stop because the gyms closed, the parks closed, people couldn't go out for walks. And it definitely impacted the physical health, but it also had a profound effect on our mental health. And we saw increasing cases, people coming to us with issues like mood swings, irritability, depression. And therefore, we're all, social creatures. And we're all used to our comfort zones. We are all used to a certain routine in our lives. And since COVID disrupted all that, there was a huge impact on our life, on our lifestyles. And since our lifestyles moved more towards the sedentary and more towards eating wrong kinds of foods, it impacted our nutritional status. And that was a big negative impact. The positive impact was, I think we started reconnecting more with people. We started reconnecting more with our families. We actually came to know who are the people we are living with. We realized a lot of other things that we were missing out. For some, weekends actually became weekends. And the realization that thinking about the self is fine, but thinking about others, the feeling of gratitude, compassion, all those are also important. And therefore, I would definitely not remember just COVID-19 as something that had a negative impact on our lives, but would also remember is that it as something that made us realize of the more important things that we usually missed out in our hectic schedules.
I really couldn't agree more. I think it's been a wonderful time to reframe our perspective and really see as the glass being half full than half empty. So that brings me to our next question, Dr. Avantana, which is, if you could share some nutrition and lifestyle practices to bring peace, balance, and resilience in our lives. And as you rightly mentioned, that people are struggling with feelings of anxiety, loneliness, and fear. Though we are now no more in midst of a lockdown, but those feelings have had a deep impact on the minds of some of us. So what can be some of those tips to restore our peace and harmony and strengthen ourselves?
Right. I think that's what everything looks for. The problem, all right, is there, but what's the solution, right? So I would like to address this entire thing as not one concept or not one tip. Since I, in my consulting practice, talk about wellness, taking the DESS approach, which is diet, exercise, stress management, and sleep management. So in order for us to develop a resilience around our lives, resilience to these, unpredictable factors that we come face to face, it's very important that we act on our mind, body, and soul in unison, rather than just addressing one aspect of our being as the entire entity. So rather than just trying to act on our bodies to look good, to feel good, we have to act on our minds as well and nurture our soul. Because ultimately, our entire being is composed of these three. We are nothing without a soul. We are nothing without a mind. And of course, we are nothing without a body. Who would actually see us? Taking these three in separate points, let's address the mind the first, because that is the most important. As we say, the CPU of the computer, we call it the brain, the mind, and yet it's the most neglected. We hardly talk about mental health. We hardly talk about foods that we need to nurture our brain. We hardly talk about exercises that we need to do on a regular basis to have sound mental health. So my tips for a sound mind would be start eating positive thoughts. Start surrounding yourself with positive people. Start surrounding yourself with positive books, positive quotes, and positive social media. Because social media is it has become almost like a shadow for us, which we all like to indulge in, but we have to set our boundaries. Because everything that's on social media is not for your consumption, is not for your good. So we need to have this discretion. We need to be cognizant of the fact that social media to some extent is great, but an overdose is definitely not right. Mm-hmm. Meditation is a great tool to strengthen the mind. Because through meditation, we become self-aware. We get into a habit of controlling what we put in our minds and what we let our minds retain. If you get that habit of trying to retain positive thoughts, trying to retain what benefits you, and reflecting, you know, just as a mirror does, or let's say a shiny sheet does, it reflects whatever is not needed. So we would have to train our minds to think positive, to feel positive. And meditation is a great way to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Another great tool is cultivating emotions which bring a positive surge in oneself. Things like gratitude, being thankful for things that we have rather than cribbing about things we don't have, which we most often do. Now, as you rightly mentioned, we should look at the glass being half full rather than half empty. Mm-hmm. Empathy for others.
Mm-hmm.
And I think COVID-19 has really taught us that we have to be compassionate for people who are, you know, we all saw that migrant exodus that happened, that touched our lives, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And we saw so many people coming out on the streets to help the people in need. Then more often than not, you know, we in our fast-paced lives don't even know who our neighbor is. But during the COVID times, we reached out to our neighbors to find out if they needed something.
Mm-hmm.
So those things bring a very positive surge in yourself and you feel good about yourself.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Few other emotions could be hope,
mm-hmm.
love, affection, self-esteem,
mm-hmm.
self-care. Because, you know, we're sometimes always worried about caring about others. And in that process, we forget to care about ourselves.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Therefore, it's very important that you care about what you're feeling, care about your needs, and develop self-esteem about yourself, that you are good enough.
Mm-hmm.
Don't compare with other people all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Because you actually don't know what they're going through. You just see the periphery and feel, oh, I'm the one who's suffering and the other person is fine. But you need to change that mindset.
Mm-hmm.
Acceptance.
Mm-hmm.
We need to train our mind to accept things and not constantly try to change them.
Mm-hmm.
Because you don't know. Probably what's happening is for your own good. And last but not the least, a very important tip and a positive emotion to cultivate for the mind is letting go. Because that is what we forget. We keep on clinging to one thought or keep on clinging to something that's bothering us and we just don't let go. So please take it easy. The world will be fine. You don't have to shoulder everything on your, you know, all the responsibilities yourself. Let go.
Mm-hmm.
And that would so much peace to yourself. You know, just try it out and you would realize it yourself. For once, if the internet is not working, let it go. For once, if you are not getting your favorite cup of coffee, let it go. For once, if the deadline has passed by a few hours and you were busy spending quality time with your kid, with your family,
mm-hmm.
let it go.
Mm-hmm.
So those things bring a lot of peace.
Mm-hmm.
Now, having addressed the mind, let's come to the body.
Mm-hmm.
For nurturing the body, it's important to act on two levels, mm-hmm. the food that we put on our body mm-hmm. and the kind of exercise we do for our body.
Mm-hmm.
For food, we should largely rely on fresh produce, mm-hmm. on whole grains and unprocessed food. Mm-hmm. You know, these days we are so dependent on processed foods that most of our diet is composed of processed foods. And we have forgotten our relation to nature.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess it's high time that we reconnect with nature, we reconnect what natural foods are available mm-hmm. and try to incorporate them in our lives.
Mm-hmm.
Proteins are very important.
Mm-hmm.
We need to include good quality proteins in our diet. And this is a misnomer in most of our minds that non-vegetarian foods are the best proteins.
Mm-hmm.
And if you are a vegetarian, you're losing on your proteins and you need to just eat carbs.
Mm-hmm.
There's a great documentary, The Game Changers, which demystifies this myth mm-hmm. and explains how vegetarian sources of protein are excellent sources of protein.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, even if you are a vegetarian, be happy because you are the chosen one and you can have beans, dals, pulses, milk proteins, tofu, soy proteins. You have a big variety of proteins.
Mm-hmm.
So those should be included in the diet. Mm-hmm. And fats. I'm sure when I say fats, I would have a few raised eyebrows around there. But what I mean by fats is good fats.
Mm-hmm.
So don't just go to the refrigerator, take a dollop of butter and have it with your bread, because that's not what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about fats that are good for you. So almonds, mm-hmm. nuts and oil seeds, olives,
mm-hmm.
avocados, walnuts are great.
Mm-hmm.
Coconut is wonderful. And kind of steer away from margarines and, you know, the low fat versions that are available in the market, because low fat is another name for hidden food products that we don't need for our body.
Mm-hmm.
So choose fats which are real. Ghee is great. And having said that, I come to the second part, which is exercise, because some of you would take my word and say, well, she said ghee is great, good fats are fine. But remember, they are fine as long as you exercise and you burn them as well. So the food part done, we come to exercise for the body. It's challenging. It was challenging the last couple of months because our movements were restricted. Even now, probably some people are still not venturing out. So the best exercise for them would be the figure eight walking
mm-hmm.
that you can do in a room. And that's a great way to have some physical exercise. For most people like us who work a lot on the laptops and gadgets, iPads and stuff, very important for us to exercise our neck and the upper body.
Mm-hmm.
So that the neck doesn't get stiff. Mm-hmm. So this part exercises are very important.
Mm-hmm.
And also don't sit for longer durations of time.
Mm-hmm.
Keep walking. So take breaks, like 15 minutes you're working on the system, then take a 2-3 minute break, half an hour, take a break. So all these things would help.
Mm-hmm.
Talking about the soul.
Mm-hmm.
We need to nurture our soul.
Mm-hmm.
And how do we do that? We have to reconnect with our inner self, which we often forget. You know, that little tiny voice that we all might have heard one time or another in our lives, trying to tell us something or egging us on to do something. And we kind of quell it. No, what's this? And we just, you know, start thinking. So spirituality is important. And by spirituality, I don't mean religion.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
By spirituality, I mean something that motivates you to be a better version of yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And that way you can nurture your soul.
Mm-hmm.
Listen to inspirational music,
mm-hmm.
inspirational talks, and they all help.
Mm-hmm.
All these are tips that we can include in our lives.
Wow. I must say, someone reinforcing this, it's so nice to hear those things. And, you know, most of us, we kind of know these things at the back of our mind, but really it makes a lot of difference when there's an expert like you out there and, you know, telling us this is the right way to do these things. Which brings me to our last question, Dr. Avantina, which is if you could share some superfoods for strength and power for working professionals. And there are people who are in desk job, they could be health workers, you know, and they could be frontline workers. So if you could share some two or three superfoods which we can all incorporate in our diet.
Okay, so the first is water. Always stay hydrated.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Because when they say water is the elixir of life, they aren't wrong.
Hmm.
So we need to stay hydrated with water. Very important. And superfoods, we need to target our mental health as well as our immunity.
Mm-hmm.
Or, you know, being resilient for the future. For immunity, there are these known nutrients like vitamin D, vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin E,
mm-hmm.
zinc, selenium, and probiotics.
Mm-hmm.
These help boost our immunity in more ways than one,
mm-hmm.
and they all have important roles to play in our immune system.
Mm-hmm.
Vitamin D rich foods are mostly non-vegetarian foods,
mm-hmm.
like eggs, fatty fish,
mm-hmm.
cheese, but mushrooms, which are grown in the sun, are great vegetarian sources of vitamin D.
Mm-hmm.
Omega-3 capsules, if we can incorporate in our lives, one pill a day is great,
mm-hmm.
because vitamin D has been known to help during the COVID crisis and as an immunity booster.
Mm-hmm.
Vitamin C rich foods like amla, oranges,
mm-hmm.
Other citrus fruits like lemons, then capsicums, berries, broccolis, they're all great.
Mm-hmm.
Vitamin E is found in wheat germ oil, almond oil, and other oil seeds and nuts. Vitamin A is another name for carotenoids. Mm-hmm. So carotene, so carrot is great for that.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So those are wonderful. Then we need to incorporate whole grains because they also boost our mental health and also are good sources of zinc for immunity. Oysters, other seafoods.
Mm-hmm.
Flax seeds, chia seeds, sunflower seeds, they are all wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
So we should include these superfoods in our diet.
Mm-hmm.
Dark chocolate is good. So you can have that as well. Berries have great polyphenols, which are wonderful too.
Mm-hmm.
So these are some foods we can include in our diet.
Wow. That's been a bunch of useful information, Dr. Avantina. And I'm sure our audience is going to really benefit from your tips and advice. And on that concluding note, I want to just say that everybody hopes that the world will recover from COVID-19. But let's press the reset button and create a new normal whereby eating well becomes the norm. Let food be thy medicine and medicine be thy food. As part of recovery, let's do everything we can to open the floodgates of nutritious food, taking unhealthy foods and their relentless promotion out of the spotlight, and support the resilience this pandemic has shown. We need more than ever, which is the health and well-being of all. And with that, Dr. Avantina, thank you once again for being part of Expert Panel. And I do hope if people have any questions, they can reach out to you. They can post in the comments box. And thanks once again for making time to be part of our initiative.
The pleasure is all mine. Thank you for having me.